After my video on publishing your Windows.NET MAUI app, I got a lot of questions. Can I do this without an MSIX file? In this video, we're going to find out. Earlier, I've created a video on how to publish the Windows version of your .NET MAUI app. You could use it to do that to the store. You can use it to sideload that. But in essence, you would have to create the MSIX file, right? And MSIX is a sort of built-in installer for Windows that makes it very easy to distribute your apps. It will automatically install the prerequisites on the user's machine. It will do all these kinds of things, so that will make it very easy. But a lot of people are used to kind of like the traditional way of distributing Windows apps, which is basically just build the app, grab all the files, put it on another machine, and it works, right? That's how we are used to work with Windows apps. But you can still do that. Actually, I think the support for that is kind of like still in progress for WinUI apps, and WinUI apps is what we are using for our .NET MAUI apps. But we are now up to a point where we can actually create unpackaged apps in .NET MAUI. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to do that. Here in Visual Studio 2022, I created a file new .NET MAUI app. Now, I'm not going to run this. I trust that you've been following my channel for a very long time. Speaking of which, have you subscribed yet? So you've probably seen a file new .NET MAUI app by now. So I set it up for Windows. Of course, it also runs on all the other platforms. And there is two things that we want to do to make this run on any other machine. So first, let's go to our Solution Explorer, and we want to edit our CSproj file, so our project file. So right-click on your project, and then you can say Edit Project File right here. And what we want to do is add a new node here somewhere in a property group, doesn't really matter which one. And we can say Windows Package Type, and we need to set that to none. That's basically something that's needed to, you know, not have it packaged. What we probably want to do is take the condition of one of these so that this only is included whenever we are building for Windows, right? So condition get target platform identifier is Windows, so it doesn't interfere with like the other project targets. So you can just use this one. Better safe than sorry, basically. I didn't test if this works or not. The other thing, so step two, this was already step one. That's how fast it goes. This was already step one. Step two, go to the Solution Explorer again, and you want to go to the Properties folder and have this launch settings.json. And here we have a command name that's called MSIX package, and we don't want to have the MSIX anymore, right? So what we're going to do is just say project here. Whoops, project, and then save that. And that's everything that we need to do. So now you can just say, go back to your Solution Explorer, right click, build. And now it's going to build. I've set it up for the debug configuration. You can do this for a release. You can do .NET build if that's what you want through your pipeline. And it's going to start building our application. And now if you have been working with WinForms for some time, then you might know that the distributable is just going to be one exe and that's it. That's not going to be it for this. There's going to be a lot of DLLs which have like the .NET MAUI bits, of course, and all the other dependencies that it needs. So it's going to be a lot of files that you're going to have to distribute, but you can zip it. There is another concept, which is the single file, I think it's called, where it's kind of like packed into one exe still, but under the hood, it's kind of like a zip file, I think, and it will kind of like zip on the fly, and then it will run the application automatically. I think that's something that's still explored for WinUI and .NET MAUI as well, so that's kind of going to be the next step. But for now, this is it, and you can kind of like inspect the exe and run that on other machines. So let's just wait for this to build. Here we are. Build succeeded. So what we can do now is again go to our Solution Explorer, and I can right click and say open in File Explorer, and whenever we do is going to open the file which has our project. Then I can go to bin debug NET6 Windows, this one. Now I have to find my executable name, which is the same name as my project, and whenever I double click this, it's going to start my application, where that could only happen if I packaged it into an MSIX and installed that before. And now you can just run the exe file like this. I can copy this to another machine and it will run there as well. Now, while this might seem very easy, it is very easy to set up, it runs automatically, but there is a word of caution here because I've mentioned it a couple of times now, it's not as easy as a WinForms application, right? This is a lot more complex, there's a lot more things at play here. We have the WinApp SDK, so your client, your user now has to make sure that the WinApp SDK is installed. Another thing that you need to have installed is the Visual C++ redistributable package. You need to make that available on your user's machine machine yourself now as well. That's all stuff that would be taken care of whenever you install it through an MSIX. So that's kind of like, you know, pros and cons, whatever you want to do is up to you. Now you have to get all the prerequisites on the user's machine yourself. But if you do that, you can just take all these binaries, zip them up, send them to somewhere else, and they should be able to run the application just as well. I hope you enjoyed another one of my videos. Please click the like button so that the video will automatically spread through all of YouTube and other people can benefit from this as well. I thank you very much. And of course, there will be more videos. In fact, there are a lot of more videos already. Check out this playlist for more .NET MAUI content. Check out this recommended video just for you. And check out this button if you're subscribed to my channel already. And I'll be seeing you for the next one.